it comes to SDGs and how far we are when it comes to addressing women issues. So that's one of the key things we do as women in GIS in trying to bring about or use data analysis tools to ensure that gender equity, we get to where we're supposed to get to in terms of the SDGs. So for my presentation, we're going to focus on 14 of the SDGs, since those are directly linked to how we're doing in terms of gender and pushing for equality. So I'm going to talk about the SDG gender index. So the survey focuses on the gender index. So the gender index came about last year in 2018. Equal Measures is an organization that runs towards or focuses on using data to ensure that gender equality, we achieve gender equality as part of SDGs. So we created an application for this, which is a dashboard that aims to look at how we are doing in terms of the issues that address women and the issues that women think are important on the ground. I'm going to do a demo for that, for this particular session, which is a survey that focuses on the results that came from that survey. So the survey focused on three regions, but I'll narrow it down to Africa, since this is an AfriGeo forum. So we're going to look at what women or what gender advocates think should be prioritized in terms of policy. And then there's also health. When it comes to maternal health, how are we doing? What's the progress you're making on the ground? So we have it's an interactive dashboard. You get to filter what area you want to focus on. So if it's you want to look at how Asia is doing, how North America is doing, and how Africa is doing. I think it's also, numbers don't lie. For part of the statistics, you'd notice how our priorities are very different based on the regions you're coming from, right? So when you look at, for example, there's a very big disparity between what gender advocates in Africa think should be prioritized in terms of policy and what the others in the other regions think of. So when you look at, for Africa, we have economic empowerment and access to land, right? Which touches on SDG number one, poverty. So what the SDG gender index does is it looks at all the SDGs and breaks down the components of gender that need to be addressed within each SDG. So within the third one, which is economic empowerment, so this touches on the laws on women land rights and how we are doing in terms of policy. What does the policy that these countries have talk about when it comes to women owning land or access to education? So economic empowerment also comes about with education, right? And education is part of SDG number four. So all these indicators link up to all the SDGs that we have. And at the end of the day, I think the most important SDG, which is gender equality, will purely be influenced by us achieving all the other SDGs. So when it comes to maternal health care, which is SDG number three, how are we doing in terms of reproductive health rights? How are we doing in terms of family planning issues? So I'll narrow it down to the survey for Africa. So we probably did one dashboard that purely focuses on Africa and how we are doing in terms of the issues on the ground that women think should be addressed for the different factors that were being analyzed during the survey. So we still have gender-based violence is the biggest issue we have in Africa. Then we have economic empowerment and equality when it comes to education. But now I also, you know, to notice for the, maybe so people in policy, I think it would be important to note that the reason why we had the first dashboard is just to show how, yes, gender equality issues occur in different countries, but you notice the ratings are very different. Which is one of the very key components that came out very differently is unpaid women pay gap, right? So you notice in Africa, this is not a very big issue, but in other regions, that's a very big issue. So which raises the question someone asked yesterday on us getting policies from other regions and having it directly adopted into our regions. But you notice when you look at the numbers, then maybe our priority should not be based on this, because this is not a big priority in Africa. So we still have other issues that we face in Africa that's not a big issue in all these other regions. So with the issue of gender-based violence and also the issue of education for all. So as part of the Women in GIS initiative, part of what we do is also develop data analysis tools that can be used to enable decision making. So what do the numbers say on the ground in terms of data or in terms of visualization? So I'll take us back to the PowerPoint. before I wind up on my presentation. This is a live link, so I'll share the link for anyone who'd want to interact with the indicators and how we to just understand the SDG gender index. And then we have the, we listed the high priority areas that we have as a region on what's important to focus on in terms of achieving the SDGs. So I think I have like 5 more minutes. So part of also what we do within the so as part of the Equal Measure Gender Index that is currently taking place. So the slide summarizes the 14 SDGs that directly link to gender equality and how we can push for enabling minority groups prosper as a part of the 2030 agenda. So we'll share the live link to that. And then we'll also talk about part of other things that we do as women in GIS. Apart from collaborating with gender advocates by developing tools that support data-driven analysis, we also provide a sustainable mentoring platform for people in universities. So some of the universities we've worked with is Kenyatta University, where we had a postgraduate session for the students there. And then we also have a training for University of Nairobi, which focuses on how to use data analysis tools to empower the youth and also grow them in terms of job creation. So part of also what we are doing is the Women in GIS Job Shadow Program and Meet Your Mentor sessions, which we run as part of our initiative. So we just have some of our previous engagements on with universities and panel discussions on technology and how we can push for open governance and the use of open data to power up decisions. I think that's it for my presentation. Thank you so much.